tail is.
Well, no, because boxes are all diabetic.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, this is Andy. Well, type two.
Oh, yeah.
Another Chinese.
We're just gonna give you, we're gonna be giving you guys sugar like crazy. I'll come in with a plated donut.
That's all right. Go right ahead.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Well, Jeff had it from Tanzania.
Oh.
I got one minute on. We're the father.
This way you can see their expressions.
Only one which I can't hear anything anyways.
We're gonna vote that too.
We'll bring the meeting to order. I'm the vice chair, so I'm gonna be just doing a couple things. We'll get a new chairman and then we'll proceed to everything else.
Young guys, they were young, but they're not anymore, sorry.
At this time I'll take nominations for chair.
I nominate Bob for chair.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Benigari, you want to, oh, there's another chair.
Nominate Andy for vice chair.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
How are you supposed to?
Now you can have to do the channel.
I'll work on the notes, we'll do that. We'll do that later on. All that's going to be down the notes.
Checks is next.
Sure, yes.
When we get down to, wherever that is here, we'll follow this down, we'll get the notes and pay sheet. Do the checks and then, two that you have your choice of get out and get one of those. Then we use the kit in here so he can get back and do his stuff, then we can.
Yeah, you don't get to read anymore.
Am I reading?
You can't read at all.
So all you do is have me read, make sure those numbers equal what we're saying.
I'm reading, right?
You're reading.
Alan Lecherry, 96174. Jared Arsenal, 55854. Joseph Pruitt, 67935. Karen Clement, 935.77. Sharon Copeland, 454.13. Wayne DeMeritt, 1,040.67. Kiki Donaswall, 26.32. Pamela Frederick, 128.83. Kenneth Gauthier, 689.93. Warren Graham, 514.63. Kip Kaiser, 718.86. Michael Kilrain, 763.44. Alva Kazaka, 946.86. Joyce Miller, void. Wayne Robinson, 11-22-10. David Rory, 8-11-19. Brenda Silva, 495-40. Jeremy Smith, 638-02. Catherine Sopronis, 738-90. Kathy Sandalea, 561-97. Dave Tubby, 580-89. Brett Wall, 781-81. Kelly Wilson, 599-64. Horace Wood, 740.94. Daphne Watt, 457.46.
Wow.
The total is $15,947.39.
That all goes to Joyce.
That goes to Joyce.
That all goes to Joyce.
This goes to Joyce?
Yep, she says all of it.
That goes to Joyce.
She gets all the boys.
Thank you.
Phyllis Reed.
We'll get Bill something, we'll do.
Check, go ahead.
Yeah, I don't have to say.
Yep, then you send a check.
Is that what you?
I need a pillow. Don't you need one too?
She just sits on the edge. She lives on the edge.
$391.13. George Abel, $661.48. Christine Belanger, $683.89. William Ferrara, $96.97. Michael Greeley, $705.48. Marcus Turner, $486.28. Jeremy Worcester, $592.13. Joyce Kegel, $322.29. Richard Mulbray, $14.78. Olivia Wall, $29.56.
Total of $3,983.99.
The library, I'll come to the sheet and they do the library.
Grand total, $19,931.38. All right, Bill's gonna love me for this one.
Oh. He's got me.
These are all the AP, CAP of the bills.
Aflac, $938.65. Air Gas, $36.25. Alpha Graphics, $2,453.68. AmeriGas, $925.12. Citizens Bank, $9,000.
Thank you.
Citizens Bank, $9,756.69. CNM Clean, $12.50. Crystal Rock, $35.88. Hartman Oil, $459.81. Health Trust, $21.15. LCB Transport, $839.50. Mitchell Municipal, $373. Peter King, $65. Quill Corporation, $131.99. Ray Allen Manufacturing, $73.58. UNH Technology Center, $120. UniFirst, $26.47. Valic, $317.41. Verizon Wireless, $160.04. WB Mason, $192.44.
For grand total of $18,176.66.
Two rec checks?
Yes, just these people.
Payroll taxes.
Thank you. Thank you.
These are checks paid out of the rec fund.
So what's this, what am I doing?
You just sign on the bottom.
I'll just sign it.
You're approving these checks to be paid out of the rec fund.
Could you, Joyce, it's the one for Aaron. I'm going over there afterwards, go through my questions. If you want, you drop it off.
Sure.
No, we get that, we have Sam.
We have David.
Oh, sorry.
We just go around and then right back to the first.
We snake it kind of along.
The paper next to your water bottle is what Joyce is gonna go over next.
So Bob, why did they put that folder in his mail slot, so if you wanna take the check, I don't need to get it.
Yeah, cause I'm going over there and I'm not.
Is he on the outside of the door?
That's it, and then you see that to Joyce and she'll.
Joyce is gonna go over.
David's door?
Oh.
She goes over, yeah, this all I copy. She just reading that.
Yep.
Okay, weekly treasures report, 3/20/2018. Previous balance, $19,869.22. Deposit, $67,787.80. Payroll, $19,931.38. And direct deposits were $15,947.39. With checks at $3,000. $983.99. Payroll taxes, $4,969.84. EAP is $18,176.66. I'm not gonna transfer any money this week, and the account balance is $44,579.14. And the unrestricted balance is $3,364,088.14.
Thank you, thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes.
At least.
You too?
Oh, yeah.
Is he with that four?
Oh, yes.
Prince of Man.
Probably about $45,000 in fees and another $7,000 or so. Keep the doors open for another week, maybe. So, first we have, which one is this? 78 North Road. And this is Brittany Scanlon. And this is for a rehab renovation.
So what do I do?
And run up the bottom, then he looks down, he comes back.
And he gets to go around.
And comes back and zigzag it, right back to kill.
So with the same address, we have an electrical permit and a plumbing permit.
Same address.
Electrical and plumbing?
Electrical and plumbing.
Alright, so it is two.
Next we have 13 Northwood Drive, and this is for a deck. So I forgot to tell you who it was for, sorry. Six Wilson Way, this is River's Edge. And this is for a room in a basement of a new dwelling. Nine Wilson Way, River's Edge. And this is a new dwelling.
It's the same house, yeah.
And we have 10 Wilson Way, again River's Edge, and this is for a new dwelling.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Ed? No, I don't know if I'm gonna have this.
And then we have 319 South Road, and this is an electrical permit. And this tool, 336 Mill Road, and this would be Schmaltzer.
Spring is healed and all this stuff.
Doesn't seem like spring when it goes high.
After tomorrow,
there's another snowstorm coming.
No.
It doesn't seem like
no.
It's 80 degrees.
Yeah. Pretty soon, just.
And did you meet with Jackson on the foundation, or did they just tell you over the phone?
Jackson came on Saturday morning. I met with him previous. And threw the water, got an injection in. And the last I checked, it was dry.
Sweet.
And I signed off on that at this point in time. I don't know if that made it to the table tonight. And I have contacted Mr. Lennon to go down and look and get a price on doing
drywall and stuff, yeah.
So it's roughly 18 feet in the furnace room and roughly 20 feet outside. And I have some pricing on it, my estimate and a proposal.
You think you're gonna go back with the Marlite or?
Either a PVC base with MR board on top of it, or we could do the FRP or Marlite panel. The furnace room is just gonna be 5/8 drywall again.
Yeah.
And that Marlite would only work on that one section, basically. In the closets, I guess I just go with the MR board. Because there's no insulation on those walls, it's just that outside wall.
Okay.
So, you know.
I'm just thinking about water.
Right, that's why I was talking maybe the PVC board for the baseboard, like a 1x4. The water gets about 3 inches.
Yeah, that's smart. Then we got problems. So open up the door, let it run out. So, cool. Thank you.
You want to just like fill us in?
The basement, there was where the furnace room is.
Oh, I see.
In the rec room.
I know, I was there, so.
Yeah, with all the shop back into the water.
Yeah, I know.
So we just stop, that's good.
So, again, so I've done a memo with, the proposal was for $1,000.
Right.
My guess on the price was like $700. Do some back and forth, do whatever. Question is, you want to go forward to get it repaired? If nothing else, it ought to get cut out and
I make a motion to at least cut it out. Start that process and $1,000. Motion for $1,000. We have to fix
second
it. It's going to get worse. If we don't take care of it, it's, yeah, we're basically letting the building see.
Yeah. Is taken from the building maintenance fund.
Well, yeah, but I always try and work things as best as possible.
Yeah, so it might be less.
So, you know, that's the cap.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Thanks. Thanks for the
counts.
Run quickly, you can.
Grange? Oh, what's going on with Grange?
The renovation and the...
Well, Grange here for that, too.
Kip, do you want to participate with the Grange? Might as well come back up.
We have that, oh, you have it right there, right?
Yeah, there was one of the nail too, but...
There was one of the other, Kip, the other.
That's the one for, yeah, that's the one.
Well, I met with the fire chief today. Does everybody have this report?
Yes, it was in the...
Was it in the...
Yep.
See inspection?
Yeah.
I did inspection.
And basically, we can't do anything until we get an engineer.
So you need stamp plans and everything else, right?
He's got to have something. He will give us the opportunity, probably for, you know, a historical building, but he won't even do that until we have some type of engineered plan. There's no question the doorways need to be fixed. Those have to be automatically to be able to open to the outside. Some of the doorways have to be enlarged, and it has to be a direct pathway, which we were going to do anyways with the new stairway. The other question is, we still got to have the mechanical room downstairs totally separate, and it's going to have 2-hour fire
burn rate.
Yeah. So that would have to be redone there, you know, enclosed and moved and so on and so forth. But basically, he doesn't want to give us permission to not do some of these things unless it's engineered.
You know how much that's going to cost?
I don't know.
I had a suggestion. So I didn't read this, but basically the general concerns were to find out what it is, classify it, and then have an engineer see how it assessed the code. So we have SFC that we use for fire protection, and that's what this main concern is. So it might be a starting point to do a rough plan and see if SFC could take and analyze that without going to an architectural firm, engineering firm, and then we're still gonna have to go through SFC or some other form. So it might be a shorter path to get where we wanna go, at least see where we're gonna go.
Do you have any idea what the estimated cost of that would be?
I really don't. I did not look into it. But I could shoot you a price.
I can check with Kathy tomorrow.
Yeah, because we're kinda, I'd like to proceed with that, but I don't know how much we would need to approve.
Yeah, no, we have no, I just thought we ought to bring this back to you to see where we are from here, what we can do to get it moved forward, or if we could even do it or not, you know? If we can have it, like you say, you know, engineered, roughly engineered and so on and so forth, and then we got some idea of what the cost is.
Yeah, and most of the time you're gonna get an engineer who's gonna kinda give you a gauge for.
Right, so.
That's why it's E, and that could change price, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, instead of spending money on the architectural plans first, to have it looked at by an engineer, let's see if we could do it with what we have and get an analysis that way.
Yeah, so why don't we table this until next week, and then maybe you'll have an idea of roughly how much.
Right, and I can do a quick call and find out how much information they're gonna need to do what we want them to do.
Yeah, and then we'll have the cost, and then we can make a motion for that.
Yeah. Okay.
So we'll table until next week.
Sounds good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Move last 2 minutes.
Second.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So he's just sitting over there.
Last week's minutes.
Speak up, I can't hear.
Last week's minutes, we approved the BP.
I was here, but I wasn't part of the thing, so that's fine.
Would we know if it's anywhere else?
Do what?
The chief of, or she?
Chief, come on up. You're next. Next contestant.
Uh-oh.
Price is right.
So just my update for things. First off. This is for you. This is just the amended bylaws. It's ready to go. And the language that was taken out was just the time clock.
Just scan it and disseminate it, and we can talk about it next week.
Yeah. So that'll sign this one.
So once you sign off on that, we'll be ready to go with those new bylaws. Okay, so Sergeant Wood's transition to evening shift has been working out pretty well for the most part. We are going to go to an online scheduling program so it's more accessible, because right now we have a hard copy and we don't know what changes are being made. So this way we get real-time alerts through texts and emails as to who's working and what shifts or what swaps and shifts have been made.
So it's kind of like master calendar that you can
pretty much. Okay. It's an online platform. It's $200 a year. So I want to go ahead and take that out of my equipment budget to do that. And then everybody has access to it. The Police Facility Exploration Committee, we're waiting for Captain Roy to kind of beef up the initial facility planning model, which is the identify and document facility problems. We have a rough draft of that, so he's actually putting together a PowerPoint presentation. So once we get that up and running, or it's completed, I think at that point you'll see it, and then we'll be ready to start our committee.
Yeah, I know, I got an email from him asking when's everyone available.
Yeah, that's
Tuesday night.
That's what the holdup. Yeah. That's, I haven't pulled the trigger on that because I want to get that done.
Okay.
And basically, I'm using Raymond PD's as a go-by, a guide. Theirs didn't get passed, but they did a really great job as far as setting that up and the process and the steps to do that. So I've been using that as a go-by for the most part. My investigator position, which is at 25 hours, I'm looking to bump that up to 32 hours a week. I'm finding that 25 hours really isn't sufficient enough time for the volume of investigations that are coming in and the follow-up that's entailed with those investigations. So I talked with Karen, and we'll probably do it on a week-by-week basis right now. When I need to use that 32 hours, I would like to use that.
He has to stay below 32 as a retiree, and then, I don't know, 32 is the trigger for health benefits, so that's...
Right, and she just has to stay within her budget.
I came from an operational safety meeting, SAU 16, which is just concerning solely law enforcement right now. And I just learned that Swayze School will be installing video surveillance throughout the whole school, because right now they only have one camera on the front door, and that really needs to be ramped up, and they're in the process of doing that. So that money should be coming in May, and as far as when they're going to be installing it, I'm not exactly sure, but I would anticipate that that should be ready to go by next fall. So with that, you know, my plan is to see if we'll be able to have access to that video surveillance system. I think there's a good probability that we'll be able to, because I know other surrounding communities have that access. Stratham, Exeter, they're able to have that access to that video surveillance system, which will be good for us.
Yes, Mark.
Are parents going to be aware of that surveillance of inside the building?
I would assume so. I don't know what the school plan is as far as putting that information out there.
Yeah, I guess that would be something we'd probably have to put the school board to ask them. Maybe purview, I guess.
I just have not received anything of it. Anything to my knowledge that they're going to be installing these cameras.
Yeah, I
as a parent, it's something that I would definitely want to be aware of.
Mm-hmm. And I just found that out today myself, so it's fairly new. It just kind of came up, and my understanding is they're looking around sometime in May. And that actually came from the security consultant, if you will. Retired Chief Rich Kane from Exeter PD actually works for SAU 16, and he's doing a phenomenal job over there as far as updating the safety and the security measures on all those schools, and Swayze's being one of them.
Thank you.
So the other thing is coffee with the chief. Anybody that would like to meet with me, it's going to be April 20th from 9 to 11 at the rec center. So
that's a good idea.
Yes. And then in the works right now is an operational plan for the Swayze School for any critical incident. Right now we have run cards, but we're looking to update that to an operational plan. And then lastly, I did check the basement, and the majority of the equipment in the basement can be sent to, we can get rid of it.
Great.
So I've got Sergeant Wood on that right now. Hopefully within the next couple of weeks, he'll be in that basement clearing that out. So the way that works, we have a contract with propertyroom.com. It's great, actually. They come, they take the property that we no longer need, and then they'll auction it off, and we'll get whatever. I wouldn't hold up too much.
I don't see too many 1989 Crown Vicks.
But before we do that, I mean, once we have a list of what's going to be outgoing, I'll be running that by you, and we'll be giving the final, obviously, the final blessing on that. And once I get your authorization, we'll have them come and pick it up.
I've been helping you for years. 45 keyboards, please.
Yeah, I don't. I wouldn't hold out too much hope for any big paycheck coming in for that.
No.
And then lastly, I have my first Rockingham County Chiefs meeting coming up this Thursday, so that'll be very informative, and I'm looking forward to that. And the last thing I'm gonna do is just make sure that all the departments are aware that we do have a canine online now. So we are fully certified, fully trained, and up and running.
How often does he have to go back for weekly?
He's required to go every 16 hours every month.
Oh, wow.
And we've got it built into his schedule right now to be able to do that, so we've got.
Where does he go for that?
Boston Canine Academy. So I'm very happy with where he's going. The state police train at Connecticut State Police, which is very reputable training, and then a lot of municipalities, obviously ourselves included, train at Boston Police Academy. So the training is up there, it's top of the line. So I'm very happy with that. And that's all I got.
Did you know Mr. Constantino died today? Remember, he was the chief over at Atkinson.
Oh, I did not know that.
Yeah, he died this morning.
Oh. Was he ill?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Did not know that.
He was up there.
Well, thank you for informing me.
Oh, that's okay.
Okay, that's what I got.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
You too.
We start to do sign on what you need.
No, we have.
Alright.
You wanna do that?
Still in the notes.
Lori, Gagnon?
Hi.
Hello.
Come right back. My name is Lori Waltz Gagnon, and I am here as representative of Hayden. So I think there might have been a little bit of confusion. Haven is the Violence Protection Support Services Agency that serves Rockingham and Stratford County for victims of sexual and domestic violence. We merged 3 years ago. Prior to becoming Haven, we were Sexual Assault Support Services and a State Police. And the town of Brentwood provided funding to each of those agencies individually. When we merged in 2015, I think we had a lapse in submitting our paperwork. So last town meeting in 2017, I attended and spoke, and we got funding approved. And then this year, so my understanding at that point was that then all we needed to do was submit a letter, and we would, the town would decide whether or not funding would happen, but we wouldn't have to appear at another town meeting. So this year, we submitted the letter in September, and then we got another notice in January asking for an update on the impact we've had in the town of Brentwood. And then we found out that we were sort of a warrant article, but it was misworded. There was a clerical error where Haven.
So it was disallowed.
Right. So I showed up on Saturday morning, and I was advised to come before you all tonight for some reason. So that's why I'm here, to see if that we can still receive funding for this your fiscal year.
I think we
but
can.
Karen talked. She got legal advice on it, so.
So I got a legal opinion to see if that would be allowable. The town's practice has always been for these regional associations to appear on a warrant for 3 years.
Okay.
If it's passed 3 years in a row, then it would move into the operating budget and then receive funding that way. So then you no longer have to appear at the town meeting. So this year you were slated to appear on the warrant. Unfortunately, the header said Haven, and then the actual text in the warrant itself said New Heights, which was going to be disallowed by Department of Revenue Services. So I consulted with counsel to see if that could be made amendment on the floor. And he said you could not because that changes the intent of the appropriation. So then I asked if you could amend the operating budget to include that funding. And he suggested that that would not be the best practice because it's always been on the warrant for 3 years and it should have appeared as a warrant. Unfortunately, it wasn't. And he thought that that would not have provided the residents with the proper notice that would have been required to provide the funding out of the operating budget. So unfortunately, his advice was that that would not be an allowable expenditure out of the 2018 budget.
So, because there was a clerical error made
unfortunately, yes.
By the Brentwood, residents that are receiving services from Haven, we will not be reimbursing any loan for that.
Well, if you're not seeking reimbursement, you're seeking a donation from the town.
Which directly goes to fund the services that we provide.
Right, but that's, it's a donation, so.
True, it is a donation, but it wasn't ever on our part, I guess.
Yeah, unfortunately, we also have to abide by certain things.
Much money are we talking about?
$3,050.
So, unfortunately, yeah, it was disallowed based on how it was worded, so we couldn't change it.
Is there any way we can look at it later in the fiscal year if we have an extra?
Somebody has a claim or?
That's up to you guys, I mean, DRA doesn't oversee expenditures, so they will be out of it, but.
Well, actually, we could. Could you really do that, because the money was already appropriated for a specific thing?
Well, you could spend it out of warrant articles, but you could spend out of budget if you had a.
Surplus.
Surplus at the end of the year. If November, it looked like we may have an extra $3,000 in the budget that we can afford.
Right.
So then they could submit a request for reimbursement services provided.
I don't even think they'd have to request something, I think Karen can touch base with them later on in the year and see if.
We could help them.
So, if I'm understanding correctly, then we would contact you in the fall, to see where your operating budget expenses are, and to ensure that we get back on this cycle of warrant articles, do we submit the same letter, follow that same procedure?
Now, would that start the 3 years all over again?
That's your guys' call, this would have been their third year.
Yeah, we should make them start over, I guess, it's gonna, it's our fault.
So maybe just do one more time at the town meeting and then get them operating budget.
That's the thing to do, you know, let's show some good grace on that part, we messed up.
And that's something I wanna look at too, is this year is, how much do you really, 'cause we got all these charities now that are asking for donations.
Like 20,000 we give up, yeah.
So we gotta have a, that's, I'm a firm believer on, we're here to manage the town, and donations are something that, it's tough for me to say I wanna donate other people's money towards charities. That's a tough thing for me to swallow. I think that's where really you wanna ask the community that you're serving, it's tough to, for us to appropriate the money and then give it to a charity.
Well, but we gave them year one, they approved it, and they probably would have this year if it wasn't a critical, I mean, a.
And we didn't, unfortunately, we couldn't bring it before the floor because we were far.
So it's in November, we'll get extra money, we can give you that, and submit the year three, and.
Yes.
And in 2020, it should be on the ballot.
The people weren't very giving this year, so I don't know if we would have passed them.
But what it's for, though, would probably, it makes a difference what it's for, though.
I wonder if you, you know, part of me wonders if you could say, all right, this is the most we're willing to do as a town for charity organizations, and then you kind of figure out how that goes, I don't know, like you said.
Well, is that a recommendation of that on the floor, to have one budget, one.
One charitable.
Yeah, here's $20,000, first come, first served, or whatever.
And everybody that wants to come before the town, become before the town, maybe.
I think that's a discussion for another time.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It's just a thought, but. We got. Yes, sir.
I made that recommendation, this is a very good thought.
Thank you for the recommendation.
What ends up happening is you get this whole backdoor charities, not against your charity, but in general. A lot of people don't know that we did, you know, we have $17,000 that we already gave away, and then you have another in the warrant article. And it just seems to be piling up, piling up. And I believe Bob is correct, that we serve a town. Charity, I believe being charitable, there has to be an end to charity, you know.
Bob, you're not the only one that said that, if you remember the gym.
Yeah.
So if you did a warrant article and said, we would like to give X amount, 15,000, whatever monetary you come up with, and then that would be it. And if you gave it to charities that directly affected the town of Brentwood, that would probably be best.
Right.
But that's your call. But I do think that it sort of slid under the, gets forgotten about when it starts ending up as budgetary.
Agreed.
So I just wanna mention, that these services, and I understand and respect taxpayers' opinions about, where their tax dollars go. I'm a taxpayer in a different town, so I totally get that. But these services would not be, and we would continue to provide them, but there is no other organization providing these specific services to the town residents of Brentwood. So it's, I know every charity operates differently, but I think that's an important point, that, victims of sexual and domestic violence are not receiving services unless it's through Haven. And there's a number of people that don't report where they're from, so, the numbers, I have the numbers to show, the impact. There were 17 residents in the last calendar year, which cost us about $5,900 to provide those services. And we're only asking for $3,050, so, and that doesn't, that's only for people that actually disclose the town that they're from. Many victims of sexual and domestic violence don't say where they live for confidentiality and safety purposes.
Right, I mean, I don't know if there's any grants or anything else out there, you guys get that part there.
Oh, trust me. I don't do this just for fun, to show up at town meetings. Yes, we have an operating budget of, $1.4 million, so we're actively seeking federal, state, town, private grants, individual donations, corporations, religious organizations, civic organizations, anyone who is willing to support, what we do. So this is just one small piece of our budget, but it's important.
All right, so I guess we'll just, oh, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Go ahead, do you want to speak?
Turn off.
Just thinking out loud here, because it was, an issue that we sort of created as a town, I'm wondering if we could use the Brentwood newsletter to sort of say sort of openly that this was an omission by the town, and we want to just make it aware that that these services are important, and that if there's people that would like to privately give money, that there's a gap between the services that they have provided and the fact that they're not getting any funding. I understand that that is something that we couldn't do for every charity, but this is our issue, and I'm wondering if we couldn't make
some room. Anyone can submit to the Brentwood newsletter, I think.
Yep.
So you could,
anybody,
if you wrote up what you, your group does for Brentwood, you could send that in for the next monthly newsletter. And
is that information on your town website?
I think, well, the Brentwood newsletter is, and I think, I mean, yes, there is information there. And if you could, and I would be happy to help off that.
I'm going to press on Friday. If you get me an article before Friday, I'll get you.
Okay, thank you so much. I really appreciate that.
Bob, I just had a quick question. Since I'm here, I might as well get my money's worth. On the question that he brought up, I think, is a good one. So I actually heard the speech a year ago and did vote for that Haven. I was very moved by it, and I think it's very important. But at the same time, I was overwhelmed this year about something about 30 of us joked last year, wait till next year, everybody's gonna be coming at it. Given what I do, people come to me every day, it's very tough because they're all good things. That seems like a great idea to limit it. That's what happens in the real world. You know, you have a budget and then we have to work with it. Because I think, my guess is next year we'll see 10 to 15 items on there and growing, because now that, remember, we had people looking for reimbursement for Sacred Heart, and like, I saw it this year, it was like, oh my God, here we go.
Yeah.
And they're all good charities, so you feel horrible when everybody speaks, you know, it's there, but at the end of the day, we only have so much money to work
right.
with.
Right.
Yeah, that's valid.
How do we do that, though? That's my question. How do you do that? What
the town
of Exeter
has a committee that looks at that stuff. That's what they do.
You can start a petition and bring it as a warrant.
So that then we create all future charitable things are directed that way.
Yeah, it's a couple different ways.
I guess that's something
I can follow up with you with an email. I just want to know how to put something like that in place.
I guess that's something I would have Karen look at, is how can we, because we already have $14,000 that we're already allocated now.
That's
part of the operating budget. And I think you have to somehow pull that and then figure out, is it $20,000 that you set? It's got to be, we got to come up with something. And then probably, yeah, maybe set up a committee that takes care of that. I guess that's something we'd have to look at. That's something that can't settle today, but.
No, no, I'm just, if you find a way of what we can do, put that into play, so that for future years, you know, obviously we'll have one more year of the floodgates open, but maybe in future years, those warrants are direct, instead of warrants.
It's easy to close the floodgate, you just turn it out.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, if I can do two things. One, if no one from the town's apologized for this screw-up, I'm sorry that we didn't get to discuss it and vote it on Saturday. And since the topic is up for discussion, do you know how many things that we fund in the budget that have passed that three-year mark?
You left.
I know.
I asked the same question.
I don't have the copy of the budget in front of me, but I think there's a.
And is it all in one line item in the budget, or is it each individual thing?
They're all individual items.
Okay, no, I'll do my homework.
But it totals like 14,000.
They're in here, but there is, if I can find it real quick, at least I'll tell you.
The budget read them all off to me when I got up to the side, and everybody was shocked.
It's 14.
Yeah, it looks like we're going on.
So 14, we're going on the budget.
I can't say that on. Stay in these questions anytime I get to talk to people.
What page is that on?
It's on page 52, and I'm in the town report. And they're all listed.
Thank you.
How many are there total?
14.
So 14 of them?
How many did we vote on Saturday? Was it another four?
Four, five.
Yeah, we had a lot. Yeah, we had at least that.
I think there was six in the book, and we only did like four, didn't we? I don't remember.
Yeah, anybody have any other questions for Lori while she's here?
Well, just a statement. As one who was raising money for 35 years for nonprofits, I think it's inappropriate, my personal opinion, I think we should put a lid on it, because I think it's inappropriate for it to come out of tax funds, because all these places have professional staff, they're eligible for grants, they're eligible for a lot of resources that the individual taxpayer is not privy to. So I want to put a clamp on it. I think it's too much.
Noted.
Noted.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I just.
Yeah, just in case one of us is out of the office. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you want to go back to the notes? I mean, I have a lot of documents. Thank you.
Yeah, let's go back to the notes. Oh, hi, Jeff.
Shall I read them off for you?
Yes. Yes.
That's your job now.
Okay.
No.
Am I doing it? You're doing it.
I'm gonna, we already did, we got a designated rep for sure. Do you stay on CBA?
Sure.
David, I think I'll take budget committee. Bill, would you like, you do school board?
Hi. Nice to see you.
I'll do conservation.
I still have the minutes you made.
No, I think it'll actually.
It's all wrong.
A lot of the meetings are worse.
That quick?
Really quick?
I can do that.
I have to be on the road by nine.
Yep. So, folks.
Oh, your school.
Yeah, in a second. Are you in a second? On favor?
Who did budget?
I'm gonna do budget.
I got Bob and Bill. Well, I got two Bs up there. I got Bob and Bill.
Two B like Bs.
Two Bs.
Begin spring schedule meeting at 4 p.m.
Do you want to continue that to the first and third, and then 2, 4, 5, is that 4?
As long as we don't have anything on the agenda, if you start having.
Yeah, that's fine.
Issues.
We don't have the world issues.
So starting the fourth.
The meeting on the third will be at 6 o'clock, and then the tenth will be at four.
The first and third.
First and third.
Or at six. And then.
All the rest are.
Yes.
sometimes you have that fit and you have to really.
We only have two and fifth in 3 weeks, 3 months.
There was last week you signed the timber warrant, and one of those warrants, one of the bills was $1,060.60. That was property cut by Charlie, that was in connection with the Southward project, so that was on town property.
Move we abate the $1,068.60.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And then the next one is request for $5,000 out of the CRF for highway addition to pay a manual for engineering plan.
So that was the blueprints for the highway addition.
Oh, for the shed.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 And then you have CPS on Thursday, Kelvin being the office.
How much more concerts you got left?
This session ends in May, and then the next session starts in July.
July. What is that, so these folks know what you're going to?
That's the Certified Public Managers Program.
You're trying to put you in the loop.
For EverSource to erect one new pole on Route 27.
If I have something to bring up, I'm gonna bring it.
After we sign all the documents.
Okay.
We said what, 27?
A pole license for EverSource.
Oh, okay.
Have Karen put on your agenda, and then we can make sure.
Can I have a motion for pole license?
Or note.
Motion.
So I can bring it up tonight?
You can, but in the future, just send Karen an email.
Okay.
It gets put on the notes or the agenda.
All in favor?
It doesn't get missed.
We got a pole.
Aye.
I have a pole for Route 27.
For EverSource to put a new, I don't want the pole license back.
Yep. Get a whole $10.
We get money.
$10.
They're gonna pay us, and then we tax them anyway.
Something you should sell drinks at the town meeting, and you're missing a great opportunity there.
We can play Keno too, if we can get 12.
And we can restrict it to beer and wine, and the police can drive us home on a cruiser.
Table to next year, no Keno till next year.
Somebody needs to.
That's what makes a little.
Someone has to get a liquor license.
Can I have a motion?
This is a land use change tax bill for 40 Old Gordon Road.
So moved.
So it's land that wasn't current use that's coming out.
Say it.
To be developed, and they have to pay tax.
Oh, yeah.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
We haven't had much of that lately.
No.
So there's that one.
So that's the bill, and then this is the warrant.
And this goes with it.
Yeah, that's the memo from Jim, and the methodology and how he gets to his valuation.
Oh, I almost signed the wrong place. I almost.
You gotta find the name.
Gotta find the name.
This is an abatement for a camper in Three Ponds, and their reason for the abatement was that they removed the property as of October 1st. But it was there April 1st, so it's taxable for the entire year. So this is a recommendation to deny the abatement.
Motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
You should ask.
Anybody opposed, no?
For what?
To not abating.
This real.
There'll probably be a lot of those this year, because that's gonna close.
This is my application for CPM for the last year of the class, so I just need my one supervisor to sign.
Do we need a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anybody against? Rita? Do you need an additional signature?
Just one.
And I have nine applications for veterans credits. Now that you've done the all veterans credits, these have all served for 90 or more days and have been honorably discharged.
I move we sign all nine applications and approve them.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any objections?
Anybody qualified, right? They're all been checked through the process?
Checked them all, yeah. The ones that are in a trust, we've looked at their trusts already.
Right.
They're gonna get like a sticker with all of your names.
Or just a stamp.
Yeah, there we go.
So closing.
Yeah, and we keep your, when
of overtime and fire and 39 in personnel, by the way. None in PD.
None in PD?
None in PD.
He's doing awesome.
Trying to barely on all snow.
I give it to Karen since she put it as part of the minutes.
Yeah, I'm getting short of
it. You always have a short of it. I guess I should do it because I keep saying it.
Before you go to public, I always have something she wants to add to the meeting.
All the legal stuff I do is more.
We still have to do.
Nobody knows who that is. Maybe that's good.
And you want your side to say, what are they all called?
And you still need to.
I'll say your last name correctly.
Bill Faria.
It's Faria.
Yeah, but nobody else says it like that.
It's Ferrari?
Ferrara.
What is it? It's Faria.
Yeah, it's like Maria, wasn't it?
Maria Faria.
I was going to name one of my daughters that.
Maria Faria.
Maria Faria? That would be like really bad.
She would probably smack me.
I guess you could have called her Faria.
That would have been. We were going to call Sarah Lee, but she.
Sarah Lee?
I got another one of those pushbacks now in Congress.
It's like calling somebody Debbie, you know, Little Debbie or something. Or Twinkie.
Yeah, it was all of those things. I figured, no, not a good idea. I'd get smacked a few times.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to do that.
Yep.
And then, Phyllis, you had something you wanted to ask?
Oh, don't we need to vote on giving Wayne the money that they voted at town meeting?
Yeah,
is that? Oh, okay. And then my other thing is, Sunday, I went on to download the minutes so I could read them all. And the last ones that were on there were February 20th. I want to know why they can't be on there after they've done and put draft on it so people don't have to wait that long to read the minutes.
They have to be approved?
No, they can be on there as a draft. You just have to say draft. I don't know if you need a motion for that or just a suggestion or.
Put the draft?
Want a motion? Do a motion. I don't have any motion.
Do you have a motion?
I mean, I'll make the motion. I don't know. Just.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
That's all.
Okay. And then we have to discuss that.
Is it for the public wants to talk first? You want to.
Well, we got to address.
Okay.
So there was the meeting and we're all there. We know that there was a motion to put in $23,000 into the budget towards Wayne's.
I think it was $23,700.
What, how did that number come up?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Except that the final discussion when they talked about that was $23,000.
No, that was going to drop the. They were talking about dropping the highway budget by 23,000.
Yeah, on the paving one.
I thought it was 23,700.
No, it was 23,600.
That sounds right.
I don't know how they came up with it, but I know we have to factor in.
The retirement. Yeah, okay, but I figured it on the wrong price today. I think 23,000.
Well, before we go forward with that, let me ask a question. Sir, we were all there.
Yeah.
Right.
The question I have. Is this a one-time, give him the money that we think he should have, and then have that part of the budget for going forward? Or was this a, we're going to increase his wages now by $23,000, and it makes a huge difference which way we interpret that. Clearly the town wants to give him more money because they think he's underpaid. But I don't know if it was intended to be. Okay, I don't know that we want to be giving people's wages from the floor at town meeting. I think that should be part of the budget process that we go through with everybody else. So the question I think we need to answer is this the money we should give him, the 23,000 and change, whatever it is. No question about that. But is it a bonus for this year and then have the department revisit his wages and his salaries as an
increase in wage.
That's not how I was.
Then the other thing is do you put it, is, I thought it was an increase in the budget, budgetary expenditures for that department, for that, for his salary, for his payroll to be
increased
up to the 23,000, but inside there, you got to have all the FICA, the retirement, everything
yeah,
else
take
to be
all
factored
that
into that.
Yeah.
That's correct. I don't have, you know, we got to still figure out the numbers, and do you do it as a spot bonus, or do you change it to a salary position versus an hourly position?
Well, the thing is, we do it as a bonus. If we do it as this year, it's a bonus, it's a 23,000, whatever, $23,000
for
purposes.
And do you do, problem is, you give somebody a $23,000 bonus, they're going to get taxed.
Let me finish my thought. So we give it as a bonus. You don't have to figure FICA, you don't have to figure retirement, you don't have to figure any of that stuff. It's a bonus. And he gets a, and you can pay it out, $23,000 is, you know, you can do it a couple thousand a month, or, you know, $1,000 a week, however we want to do it, as long as the money comes out and he's supposed to get it.
The way it was presented as a wage adjustment.
Yeah, it says
it,
it says wages.
So we
that's
need
how
to
it was presented,
his,
was
okay.
Wages.
So then what I would suggest is not even up for conversation. So it's a wage increase of $23,630, and then we have to figure out how that's going to get paid out. Is he going to stay on an hourly rate, or do you want to make him a salary and increase his wage by that $23,000?
Karen did some research on that.
All
the
other department heads are on salary. She's on salary, the fire chief's on salary, the police chief's on salary. He's the other fourth biggest.
Salary, you can do that for that position.
He could be because he oversees two full-time employees. So there is certain requirements to meet the executive exemption. He has to make at least $455. He has to be considered, one of his primary functions has to be managing a department, and he has to oversee at least two full-time employees, mm-hmm. which he meets all of those criteria.
I mean, everybody else is in salary. The other three, the two big departments.
Does that make it easier to give him the money and
just make it salary and give him that big chunk of things?
Do we give them that big chunk, or do we spread it out over?
Well, I did out the math to ink. It would come out to be $380 a week
more
mm-hmm. for his salary, and then you'd also factor in $4,325 of that goes to New Hampshire retirement, and then $2,997 is FICA.
He's going to have to get 23
so
cash. Everything comes out of it.
Yeah.
So it all comes out of that 23.
It's all.
That comes to that 452.32.
Yeah, because it's not in the budget.
So the way that it shakes out is that 23,630, it works out to be $454
a week.
And then you have to allocate all of your other expenses, so taxes,
right.
retirement,
right.
and
all
that
stuff. That sounds fair.
That's a nice.
Put him on salary.
So I say we put it on salary, but who wants to make that motion?
Well, I think maybe Karen should have a sit down with Wayne too,
and make sure that
see what
okay.
he thinks about it. I mean,
okay.
yeah,
we should get a little input from him.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
And that's his department.
Because obviously, if he's dead set against that, we need to portion some of that $23,000 to go to overtime.
Right.
So it'll make the figures different.
Right. Right. So do you want to table this until?
Yes.
But we all agree that.
He'll get the money.
For the public, he's getting the money.
He's
going
to get
the money.
This is how we're going to allocate it, and I think you're right. I think Danny's right.
But it was
get his input, find out what's going on.
See how he wants it disbursed to him as well. So
I think your way of putting it to make sure the FICA and all that stuff comes out of it
right.
is certainly fair
right.
as someone
yeah,
listening to that. That was my expectation as you.
If you give it to him as a bonus, he's going to get whacked.
Well, that's where you got to.
But it said wages.
That's not what the town meeting voted.
You got to figure out how to do.
Town vote.
Otherwise, I mean, I know if I took a $23,000 bonus, I'd probably kiss my boss on the lips. But
I'd like to see
that.
Yeah.
But I know I'm going to get railed on taxes. I mean, 50% of
it
probably sucked up by taxes. All right.
Is this salary position that you're going to offer him a salary for the rest of his employment or just for 1 year?
No, it will be a salary position.
It would be a salary position for. Or as long as he tenures that position.
Okay.
But does he have to agree to go on salary, or I mean?
He doesn't
no,
have to.
No, I mean
it can be up to
us.
It's up to the board, I think.
Is it? I don't know.
Yes.
Yeah. We just don't want to shove it down his throat. We like him to get.
Want to have
part
some,
of the conversation.
You want to have some input into him and have some discussion with him. And
he certainly deserves that consideration.
So. All right. So I mean, we'll table this until Karen has a conversation, and we'll revisit that again, but.
Karen yesterday about changing the way we sit. This is okay, I guess.
I thought we talked, didn't we talk about that?
I wanted us to turn around so that we could see everybody, everybody could see us, but the cost of a table was like $2,500 or something. Somebody suggested.
We are taking donations from you?
Yeah.
From charity org, charitable organizations.
Somebody suggested to me that maybe we could get WB Mason, when they reconfigure offices and stuff, they take the furniture back, and then they have, I don't know how often they do it or whatever, but they have furniture that they then sell back out.
I have a sawzall, we can just cut it.
The problem is, I don't think a long table would fit us across.
Yeah.
Probably not, or maybe we could just turn this table, and two people would be sitting on the ends, but we still have the idea. Well, we'd move the credenza and.
If you move the table that way, when you have planning board meetings, because they have a seven-member board plus Kathy sits at the table, you'd have four people sitting with their back to the audience.
What about you shaped?
Those are very expensive.
That's $2,500 for a table.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to get a.
Well, they could use the space.
Maybe we could talk to the, the SST, or we could talk to.
Well, I mean, a U-shape is gonna create the same issue we have now.
Yeah.
Which is.
We're facing each other instead of the audience.
Yeah.
No matter what you do, you or.
Well, the U would have to be deep enough so that the planning board could put plans on the table to review them and work, too.
So.
How much would it cost to put the table on wheels?
It's just wheel back and forth. We could probably do like a mic system or something for like $400 or so. You know, a wireless, each person have a mic in front of them and then have a speaker somewhere pointed out to the audience.
Yeah.
Yeah, cause it's difficult for the audience to hear and see what's going on.
Phyllis is very soft spoken.
No, but I know when I used to sit out there, I'd go, what the hell are they talking about?
You're the one that said that earlier.
The problem is the door was open tonight, too, and there were people talking in the hall, that, so that took out.
Well, we like to leave the door open.
I understand that, but.
She was whispering that nobody would hear.
Well.
It's nice to see all you people here tonight.
It is, it's great.
It's just hard to hear when everybody's standing in the hall talking.
Any public input?
Yes, I do. I wish to thank the board for my wonderful gifts and for all of the service that you have rendered to us and the town. Thank you, good night.
Thank you, Ken, for all the service you gave us.
Thank you, Ken, for your service, yes.
Was that a motion?
No. I'm wondering if the board would consider the following, that Robert Galacki and myself would like to form a study committee or group with respect to finding a way to film and distribute the public meeting, the board's meetings.
That's a great idea.
Crazy.
And Bob comes with incredible experience. He actually directs the Exeter television stations. He's a very able guy, and to have him on a committee would be a great asset to us as we sort of explore all the possibilities.
We had explored that. We had done that before. It was like 45,000.
But things have changed.
That's good.
And it, whereas it was prohibitively expensive,
yeah,
5 years ago, 8 years ago, Bob's got some great connections. There's some used equipment, and even if we didn't go that route, there are some other ways in which this could happen with small money, and maybe it will end up that we just, as we look at all the combinations and permutations, we can't make it like reasonable enough to even present it to the board. Mm-hmm. But we feel that we should have a go at it.
Andy had looked into this also, so I'll let him speak through it.
The suggestion came up a couple weeks ago for us to look at it again. So I've been looking at how local towns do it. So I actually have an IT guy that works with me now in my full-time job.
Okay.
So we've been talking about it. But if you'd like to start a committee, that'd be great. But what I've been looking at is maybe just doing a video hosting site where we would upload a video from the meeting, live stream it off our webpage, and then find a video hosting site, whether it be us or YouTube or Vino or one of those, and upload the videos to that afterwards. But
yeah, I mean, my question for the board was, and what is Brentwood's involvement with Comcast in terms of franchise fees or anything like that?
We pay them.
Well, I mean, people have Comcast paying, but does Brentwood receive any percentage? What is that percentage?
Like Exeter gets 5%.
I believe guys said it 3.5%.
Okay, because that's the funds you would go after to make something like this happen.
We found it cost prohibitive to do a Comcast channel and to get a professional camera.
Yep.
We looked at that 2 years ago.
Yep.
It just wasn't worth it. But like you said, the new web ability creates, I mean, you can get away with buying a digital camera for a couple hundred dollars and a web uplink for whatever, and you're good to go. Or we can just let Butch continue to...
Butch is filming, right?
I just want to see a commitment from the board to take that task over. I mean, it's as simple as a cell phone and uploading it to a YouTube channel.
Right.
But I mean, if there's a commitment for a committee to be formed and to get it on the town website so people can feel included.
Yeah, I want people to see what we're doing. So
put the lights on, maybe Butch will be proud of it. These lights are on.
Would the board have any problem with us forming that study group? I mean, it doesn't have to be a full-fledged committee or official capacity. I mean, like, that you have to take our recommendations, but... And would the board have any suggestions as to with whom you would want to represent or, I mean, to participate in this? Again, it doesn't have to be an official, you know, ad hoc, you know...
I think having a select board rep would be very helpful.
I'll be your select board rep, and...
You guys want to be part of it, and then how about you, Butch?
I'm going to just keep showing up with my camera until you guys get it all together. But thank you.
I can attest to Bob's quality of work. I've seen some of his work. He does good work.
He does.
I don't know if we want to have that kind of quality for me.
Do you put it on YouTube now?
First meeting I've been to with the camera in a few years.
Sure. I've seen it coming.
Thought we'd start off with the new board.
Yeah, that's good.
It's very, thanks, Butch.
Yeah.
I'd just be interested once you get it done how the sound is.
I'm going to guess you'll be able to hear me, probably not anyone.
So, I mean, and maybe, like you're saying, maybe just having some microphones and a speaker.
But that all part of the committee of what would work together.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if you want to get maybe Karen.
Grab my email address from Karen.
Get the email address, and then you guys can disseminate when you want to meet and figure it out.
Thank you very much.
I don't know if you heard that. Part of your process should also be looking into, you know, little mics for us or whatever and a speaker system. So part of that overall, what you're looking at. So,
There's some used equipment that's coming up, and we'll be able to sort of inform people about that.
Great. That'd
be awesome.
Thank you.
Anything else for the public?
I would just like to make the suggestion, and this is my first selectmen's meeting in Brentwood going to, because I film all the ones in Exeter. What I think is really helpful that they do is they have this public input right at the beginning, because that's when most people are going to be able to make it, and they might not want to sit through the whole meeting if they want to say something. So I would suggest moving that to the front and let, you know, your constituents be able to go before you guys, before you dive into all the tax abatements and everything else, because we might not want to listen to all that. We want to just speak with you and then leave. The other thing is, I don't see any like printed agendas anywhere, so I have no idea what you guys are doing. And I guess I could have printed it out on myself, but it's helpful if there's like a stack of them here so people can just grab them and follow along with the meeting.
Yeah, the majority of the time, unfortunately, what happens is sometimes we don't have anybody here.
Yeah,
I mean, I would say
I'd rather have,
in the
I'd
4 years I've been here, this is 95% of the time, it's just us.
Yeah, and I'd rather
know.
Well,
now Phyllis is here and she's the drawing
card. That's why I'm like, now it's like, woohoo, we got a whole audience. We had to turn the lights on.
That's why we all came.
So it wouldn't cost that much to have 10 pieces of paper printed out. This is really small.
You can use it as scrap.
Good idea.
I can say from experience that if I want an agenda, I can come and Karen has gone and run a copy for me many, many times. I'm the only person, or like Bill and I would be the only people.
Yeah.
The room is empty.
If we have an audience, we'll run and
no
make
one
a copy.
Would ever say no if you asked for a copy.
Yeah, it's just nice to have them right here.
We're conservation minded. Yeah. Saving the trees.
I'm on the trees.
Saving the trees.
So noted.
Okay.
Anything else?
Throwing us out.
No, I'm just staring crickets. I've given you the opportunity to speak.
So the new people haven't learned that it's their job to close the meeting.
Yes.
Make a motion.
I make a motion to close the meeting.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Nice job.
Hey, watch.
Yeah, it's doing well.
Done.
Should've done that in Kansas City.